Dear students, welcome and thank you for tuning in. We are continuing our discussion about design for the environment. In this video, we are going to look at the big picture about what's happening in terms of environmental impact and what those impacts are because of our industrial activities, specifically from the materials that we are using. What is the definition of environmental impact? What are the examples or types of those impacts? When we design products, I mentioned in the previous video that it's very important to look at the two challenges. First one is an energy challenge and the other one is a material challenge. Both of those contribute to an environmental impact or an environmental footprint. Whatever we do in industry or in engineering, we are going to affect the environment in some ways. And those ways could result in long-lasting impacts. In this slide, I'm showing a few of them. For example, global warming. There is scientific data and models show that the temperature of the Earth is gradually increasing as a result of the accumulation of greenhouse gases. And this effect is accelerating as a result of the emission of carbon dioxide, methane, and black carbon particles, and nitrogen oxide from industrial processes and products. This is a very important thing and a very negative impact on the environment. And this is a result of, you know, industrial practices. Another example of impact is resources depletion. So many of the raw materials used for production, such as iron or gas, oil, and coal, are non-renewable and supplies are limited. And if we look at iron, because of industry, because of our industrial activities, we create products and then we dump them or, you know, at the end of their life, cycle, they are collected and most of them is dumped in landfills. And so this way we are not putting them back into the environment in order to be reused inside a healthy cycle. And also, we in using the landfills, we are creating unnatural concentration of materials in different locations. So resources depletion is clear when it comes to oil and gas, but even in metals, this is very, very important and impactful. Solid wastes. So products may generate solid waste through their life cycle. Some of it's recycled, but most is disposed in incinerators or landfills. Incinerators generate air pollution and toxic ash because of burning, and landfills may also create a concentration of toxic substances in an unnatural way, and it also generates methane gas, which contributes to the greenhouse effect. Also, water pollution is the most common source of water pollution. Are the ones that discharge from industrial processes, which include heavy metals, fertilizers, solvents, oil, etc. And also, air pollution sources of air pollution include emission from factories, power generator plants, and so we are familiar with this, and also land degradation because of the development. And so we have a lot of effects on that reduce soil fertility, soil erosion, and salinity of land and water, and deforestation. So all of these are, you know, negative impacts. And also we have, you know, an impact on the biodiversity. If we are developing, you know, large pieces of land, we are cutting trees and we are affecting the ecosystem there. And because of our industrial activities or mining or, you know, urban development, and also again, it's a negative impact. Now, when we design products, we would like to keep in mind this kind of impact, and we would like to reduce our footprint if we are making products or processes on the environment as much as possible. If we're smart about this, we would like to integrate with the healthy or the natural life cycle, and make sure that our products and our processes are part of the natural life cycle, and which we'll discuss later on. One of the things, the impacts, again, as I discussed before, it's very important to keep in mind that we have material challenge and energy challenge. We're not going to deal with the energy challenge, but from the material challenge perspective, if you look at this chart in 1960, those are the solid wastes produced in 1960, and you can look at different materials. You have paper, glass, metal, food, and you know, different composition. However, there is something missing, a very important component that start accumulating over the years since then, which is plastics. Now, in 1994, plastics, were 10% of the solid waste composition, and that's dangerous. And the reason behind that is that plastics do not degrade easily into the environment, and they don't get into the natural life cycle. And to put things into numbers, in 1960, the waste stream, we had 390,000 tons of wastes, of plastic wastes. In 2003, it jumped to 26 million tons of solid waste. And to put it in another perspective, into percentage of how the plastic is getting more and more into our waste cycle, in 1960 it was 0.4 and jumps to 11.3. It's a huge amount of the solid waste is plastics, which are very hard to degrade and to be recycled. So it's critical, and we would like to be smart about approaching this challenge. So is this a legacy problem? Yes. Is it a material problem? Sure. Is it a solvable problem? Yes, again. And we need to be smart about how to approach this early on in our product design development process in order to be able to utilize, what is available processes and methods in order to reduce the footprints on the environment, our footprint on the environment. Now, so let's put some definitions to the topic. So design for environment is a method to minimize or eliminate environmental impact of product over its life cycle. So that's the definition. And effective design for environment practices maintains or improve product quality and reduce cost. So if you're using a product, if you are putting a lot of thinking and innovation in our products to be smart and to reduce our footprint on the environment, we will end up creating better product. And also, if we are using recycled material, we are reducing the cost of our manufacturing. And the whole thing is come down to reducing our footprint on the environment. Design for environment expands the traditional manufacturing focus on the production and distribution of its products to be focused on a closed loop life cycle that integrates the product life cycle with the natural life cycle is defined around us in the environment. Thank you for watching. Until the next video, bye.